boring, very boring.
was verstehen.
You can translate. Thank you.
Nein, das ist auch nicht nötig.
Okay, I think you just don't want to. Okay.
So now from the pessimist people, can someone say or share what makes them feel more pessimistic at this point of their lives? Like maybe not a specific event or just a general idea.
Seems half empty.
Well, for example, someone just commented, Donald Trump makes me feel pessimistic.
Somehow life repeats in parts, and I thought, oh, I have to, now I'm at the beginning where I have been for 2 years ago, so I have to start new with the same, mit den gleichen Ausgangs, the same basic somehow. Somehow I changed, but I have the same surroundings.
So why is that?
Because I decided to go away from the place I lived now, and I ended a friendship somehow, and so I started again, and I started 2 years ago, a new life, so to say, so now I'm at the same point somehow.
Mm-hmm.
And that's pessimistic in some way, for me.
The idea that now two-thirds of my life has gone, I've just one-third left, but sometimes I'm optimistic about this, but today not. I could change even, but just now I'm standing here. no specific reason.
Yeah, my main complaint is about working as an artist in Athens, which is not very bright future, as it seems.
Be pessimistic as a kind of freedom, and I thought I've always long bottom, but I can always go up, and if I'm up, I fear to fall down, perhaps, and so it's a good base.
I'm pessimistic. I think this evening will not be interesting enough for me to stay. Sorry, I would go.
But can you define what makes it not interesting for you?
I didn't know what performance that would be, and I expected something musical. And I don't know.
So it is kind of a matter of uncertainty. You feel uncertain of what is going to happen.
Yes, and I want to spend the time for other things.
Okay. Okay. Yes, thank you very much. Can you speak a bit louder, because the acoustics are very bad?
It was just a comment. The optimist's background was the pessimist. So we need a little more.
Me, I'm a pessimist because mostly I cannot stand the optimists. I just don't like them, and this is why I categorize myself as a pessimist.
Sometimes I feel that everything is constructed and nothing has a real substantial purpose. So this makes me feel quite pessimistic most of the times. Would you like to share your story? You or no? Did you choose a side? Okay. And you? I think you're the only one who hasn't shared. No, she said. But do you feel...
Do you have any complaints?
My English is not so good. I don't know what complaints mean.
Complain? How is it in German?
Erklärung, glaube ich.
Erklärung.
No,
But you chose to come to the pessimist side, though.
Yeah. It's more sympathetic if I choose one.
Why? Hello.
Hello. Bye.
Can you give us a small feedback?
Ja. Mhm. Aber auf Deutsch. Ich verstehe nichts. Zu wenig.
Schade.
Die Akustik ist schlecht, aber mein Englisch ist auch schlecht. Und ich finde es schade, dass...
Sorry, someone could translate. So I used to say. No, no, I understood what you said, but somebody that speaks both English and German could translate what we are saying during the concert to the lady so she can understand, if somebody can.
So, would you stay if we translated?
Das Wichtigste, ja. Aber es ist dann auch noch die Akustik, also man versteht hier nicht, was Sie sagen. Ist auch schwierig.
Sie können es ja
probieren. Also müssen Sie sich jetzt entscheiden. Sie haben die Wahl.
Also ich würde sagen, wir können übersetzen wegen der Akustik auch.
Ja, finde ich super.
Great. So, does anyone have any suggestion how we could, fix the problem of the sound?
Yeah. Come closer.
So, would someone from the optimist people like to share their story?
Akustisch gut. Und jetzt ist jemand Lustig von der positiven Seite mal zu erzählen, warum man positiv denkt. Optimistisch.
Ja, fang an. Ich glaube, dass ich gleich verlebe damit.
My life.
Life is more easy than she's optimistic.
Besser? Mein Leben. Wenn ich die Gedanken positiv lenken kann. Aber es ist Arbeit, es ist Übung. Es wurde mir nicht gut in die Wiege gelegt.
What?
To stay positive all the time.
With the work?
In life. Staying positive in life is not easy.
Ah, yeah.
It takes work.
It's challenging.
Yeah. How do you do this? Can you show us?
Machen Sie das für mich.
Es gibt ja, also ich kann ja mein Gehirn beeinflussen. Ich kann mir ja jeden Tag sagen, oh, das Leben ist schwer und schlecht. Oder ich kann sagen, oh, schau, wie heute scheint die Sonne, ich habe so schöne Blumen im Garten und mein Mann ist zwar manchmal ganz launisch, aber eigentlich finde ich ihn unterm Strich super. Ja, genau. Die kleinen Dinge vor allem zu sehen.
Ah, I understood this. The small things.
Ja. Ja.
And the view she takes. The view you can, the sun is shining, you can say, the sun is shining. Or if it's raining, you say, it's raining. I think that was that what she wants to say.
Ich hatte ein Ereignis, ich muss es sagen, mit einem Schmetterling. 2 Stunden und ich bin heute noch high davon.
2 butterflies.
Spend 2 hours. 2 hours.
Ah, okay.
like a society in the end.
But I think it's also a kind of classification. If you say this is a bad feeling or this is and this is a good feeling, and for me it's very important to be sad, for example. I couldn't be sad for a long time and I get hard somehow, and now it's very important for me to be sad when I'm sad.
Ah, but I do think it's the same, being sad with being
and
a person.
No.
For example, I'm not sad. I like living in Athens, but I cannot be optimist about my career there.
Okay.
So, but I'm happy, even with this. Yeah, but job is like one of the crucial parts of life, so...
Well, that was a German way, isn't it? When you're an optimist.
Well, first I was in the middle because I think it's fluctuating. Sometimes I feel very optimistic and there are also like certain times where I could change the side because I have more pessimistic feeling. And it depends on the subject. And it depends if I look at the future or if I'm with my thoughts right in the moment. So this optimism or pessimism, is depending on the subject of my thoughts or even my feelings.
Is there a specific subject that makes you feel more optimistic generally?
To feel more
optimistic.
Optimistic. Yes, there are certain issues, like especially in Germany, about the protection of our environment. For example, we are the first nation, as I think, five or more, who decided to stop the atomic power industry.
Why are you so pessimistic about being an artist when you're performing a documentary? I think that's quite cool. And like, quite a while.
Yes, but it's an exception.
To what?
To the arts field in Greece and how it's functioning.
But you're not optimistic about being here?
Not really.
Okay, why not? Why not?
You mean that if I believe that this is an opportunity for my career to start
not
being built?
Not necessarily, but just like a place to do what you want to do, or...
Oh yeah, but pessimism and optimism are for the future, not for the present condition. I'm happy to be here, but in the future,
no.
I'm pretty pessimistic.
Why?
Well, because it is very probable that we will go back to Greece and our experience here will not offer us further professional opportunities.
Yeah.
As she said, it's not about living in Greece in general, it's not that we're not happy to be there, it's about professional work.
Where were you?
Why was I optimistic? I don't have much to complain about. I have a very nice life. I feel very lucky. So I can't be sad.
Do you live here?
No, I live in London.
Mm-hmm.
London.
Are you an artist?
I'm at art school.
Sorry?
I'm at art school.
Mm-hmm. And do you come from there? You're originally English or? Yeah. Where were you?
I'm optimistic because I like to have things to get better.
Can you tell us one thing that you hope it will get better and how it's better?
Is it possible that you could give some advice to some of us here, like how we could implement this mentality you explained? Because it seems very, seems like a very empowering. And you? And where are you from?
I'm from South Korea.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you believe it's not a state of mind, but it depends on the conditions that you face.
Would you say that you are pessimistic as a person, that you're pessimistic, that you like, or is specifically your situation, your working conditions in your own country or city, that makes you a pessimistic person right now? Or are you like, have you always had like a, is it the situation that has made you a pessimist?
But isn't all the time the situations that make us pessimist?
Sorry?
Isn't all the time the situations that makes us pessimist?
I guess as a person, you have a, I don't know, maybe it's just something that things happen, but as a person, you have a tendency to go negative. Or
how is this tendency constructed?
How it is constructed, the tendency?
Yeah, is it natural? Is it in our personality?
I guess it could be a mix of how you were raised, also how depends on how you believe are your person, like before even you were sperm, or do you become, yeah, I don't know. Do you have a personality? When does your personality start? I don't know. But I guess I believe I don't have children myself, but what I've heard, it seems that you have a personality even in even if you grow up in really hard, severe conditions, like, I think you can still be an optimistic person, like, deep down. So, does that answer the...
And the rest of you, what do you think your personality is... If you had to say part of your body that your personality resides, where would it be? In the head, in the stomach, where?
I didn't just understand everything.
I heard that you said that you feel it in your gut, maybe.
Oh,
sure. Your personality.
No.
Personality.
No.
That's
no. It's just like it. Yeah, maybe you can say it with your words, but I say
even an unborn child has a personality.
Στη γυλιά της μαμάς.
I don't know, I was just like making conversation around this specific situation, it makes you a specific person right now, or is it, yes, where do you feel like generally?
I think you are the only one who hasn't spoken yet.
I cannot speak.
You don't want to speak?
No.
Okay.
I did not know the performance would be 1 hour, just jumped in and someone is waiting for me.
Would you like to give us a small feedback?
It's hard. Usually I try to stay till the end because I want to like, is there a thought of like a resolution or something in the end? Or, I thought it was difficult maybe to be here because maybe you don't know what is expected and like the energy is kind of low and like, but maybe that is the point, I don't know. Because usually, as I said, I want to stay the whole thing to like understand maybe this low energy actually has like a meaning also for me in the end.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Good.
Are you also going?
Pardon?
Are you also going?
Yeah, I really want to go outside because it's really hot. Mm-hmm. The acoustic is very, very hard. I could imagine that we can work with this acoustic in the room, but if we have a talking room, I would prefer to sit outside. Then I would stay with you and talk, but not in this room.
It's... Do you have any suggestions?
Pardon?
Do you have any suggestion what we can do?
Go out
here,
sit outside in the room.
Maybe apart from talking.
Hmm?
Maybe apart from talking.
Yeah, I have many ideas, but now I need to drink something. Dry mouth. It's too hard. Thank you.
Thank you. So how does it feel for you to be here and interact with each other? What do you think is our situation? Do you think we are heading towards being a group, or this situation has divided us, or what do you think? How would you describe the situation we're in right now?
I was going to say it was awkward, but I feel like this kind of broke the tension a bit, just now I feel more relaxed.
But why?
Sorry.
What? Would be awkward. What is the awkward thing?
Before, because I guess everyone's panicking a bit about not wanting to say anything or thinking about what to say because it's so hot or being put on the spot or
you must have had a preconception or an aim of bringing people together and trying to figure out what that would be, I guess.
And you're being filmed, which is quite awkward, and you guys are a little bit scary.
Who is the scariest?
You.
And you.
So if we could do anything we wanted, let's say we are free to do everything we want here, what would that thing be that you want to do? What would you like to achieve with a group of people like we are?
To go out and have a glass of water. A full glass of water. It's warm.
Are you not thirsty?
Sorry?
Are you that thirsty?
Yeah.
We can open this.
I think it's nice when you're in a group of people that you don't know and you have an opportunity to meet or discuss things. So I think what's happening already has the potential to be good, but it needs to, I guess,
have some kind of?
Not purpose, but just needs to flow better, or, yeah.
But this is what I was asking.
Yeah.
What can be this purpose? What would you like it to be?
So loud
now. Is there anyone who knows what he wants or she?
I would like to discuss pessimism and optimism. Of course, we started it and we have a few statements, but we don't discuss what it means. Yeah, is it a situation? Is it born? Is it a child? So on.
Okay.
Would be nice, I think.
I feel like you can be optimistic, but say it maybe can get harder to stay optimistic with age, so there is the potential to be swayed.
What did you that you get pessimistic as you get older?
Well, I don't know, I'm not that old, but I just...
Well, this might seem a bit absurd, but as I was observing our two groups, it seemed like in the optimist group, most people were young. Like, most of them, not all of them. And at least younger. Young. Like,
but we're younger than we were in the...
Yes, I mean, as percentages, like the percentage of young people in the optimist group was somehow bigger. And I don't know if this shows something, but since you said it.
Yes, actually you said something that was about AIDS.
No, AIDS, but I...
What?
Not age.
Yes, age.
I could say something about age too.
Yes, maybe this would make you feel pessimistic.
Just remember birth phase in my life. I was very pessimistic when I was 21. And then I grew more optimistic. And now I'm old, and I think I'm old. It just depends on my point of view, I think. And but I have so many things I remember.
Memories.
I think I've had a life full of developments, bad and good, and I think it's not so important whether I'm optimistic or pessimistic. It's just I think it's two part of one part of my life. I'm both. And it's both in me, and I think it's just I don't know what to say. It's important that you feel it, that I feel myself. And whether I'm bad or that isn't so important. It's just the most important for me is to feel that I'm living. Just half an hour I was struck by a bee and it's a little bit red, but I feel it's not so much else.
So it sounds very optimistic.
In the optimist side, there were some people that said that they are optimist because they have no problem in life and they're happy and they have no reason to be pessimist, like you, for example, and you, I think, yeah? Something like that. Okay, whatever. But there were, I mean, what I want to say is that there were other people that said, I want to be optimist, that this is how life works better for me. Maybe the materiality of my everyday life is not so good, but still in a mental position. I don't know if I'm saying it right, but maybe you understand what I want to say. I prefer to try to stay positive, to try to stay optimistic. The way I perceive it, it's not about being positive or negative, but it's more about being, a little bit aware of the situation you're into and to be able to foresee some things about it. Of course, things can be better, but practically, if you can foresee that things are going in a bad direction, you can say that you're a pessimist, right? Even if you can try to stay positive about it. To see it in a positive view. But I strongly believe that the situations are making us like negative or positive, and it's not a state of mind. We can still try to be more positive than we could, but it's a materiality that makes us, at least me, and I don't know, also I thought the complaints we heard were a little bit material problems, like, I don't remember them now all, but... Like being thirsty, which is the most material. Or being warm, or...
I think it's not so much a question if I have problems or not, even material problems. I think the question is how you handle it. And even in worse, very negative situation, you can do something, you can change. And as long as you have a hope of change, as long as I am optimistic, even in a difficult situation, even if I have problems.
But I think if the basics are not, you don't have the basics like water, something to eat, a house, something like this, you have a few energy to think, to even to walk, and so it depends on the point in which you are discussed, makes us discussion. If you have these basics, then you have wish for friendship and car, maybe something like this. And otherwise, I'm not sure if hope, it's sometimes it's misused, I think. So in Africa, I got the feeling that church tries to give the African people hope that they can get from zero to hero if God wants to. So they went there and thought, oh, if God wants me to be a hero, he will do it somehow. So, and I think, hey, get up, stand up, do your own thing, get against the white people and fight for your rights. Don't have this hope anymore. So it's another point somehow.
I agree with you that if human beings don't get fulfilled their basic needs, they have left nature to act. But as far as I know, as far as I have seen those people in Africa, still they have hope, even more.
Yeah, what does the church say?
I don't know if it's possible to link it with the church. I know exactly what you mean, what church does. But for me, this is not the point.
Do you ever feel guilty for being optimistic?
Feel what?
No. Guilty.
Yeah. Guilty?
Yes.
Why?
No, just this thought came to my mind now that we began talking about African countries, that maybe it is very easy for us to say how optimistic we are, how pessimistic we are in our...
I think that's a counterproductive question.
Probably.
No, just in terms of maybe, I don't know, helping other people or something like that. You shouldn't think, what's the point of having guilt? Just try and be the best person you can be and be nice to other people.
Actually, today it felt really good. Speaking with all you people, I felt that we had a very sincere conversation, and I felt that there was a kind of we were kind of equal in this conversation. This is how I felt it, and yeah, and I get the feeling that maybe this is a bit like group therapy, but I get the feeling that we are helping each other somehow, and taking this into account, I feel a bit strange that people decided to leave because they couldn't hear well or because they couldn't give enough time for it to grow. Because, for example, in the first minutes that we were there, I didn't feel that we were helping each other. I felt that it was really awkward. But now I think we have arrived to a point that we can take from each other, and I think it was worth it in that sense.